How many here are Android developers or iOS developers? Android developers, raise your hands. iOS? React Native? Any other? Alright. So, my name is Pooja Bhaumik. I'm born and brought up in Calcutta, living in Bhubaneswar, coming here from Bangalore, and I'm also a mobile developer. In fact, I always thought that I was in love with Android. But recently, I might have started an affair with Flutter. So, I mean, I'm still in love with Android, but Flutter and I have this great connection, you know. So, what went wrong? Now, it was a 3 years relationship, if you do not count that chasing period where we were getting to know each other. But Android is awesome, Java is awesome. But after a certain point of time, it kind of became a little too comfortable and not so much fun. You know that spark? That was gone. I had that phase in my life where I wanted to try out other frameworks. So I thought to myself, do I really do this one thing my entire life? So I tried out React Native. I tried out Ionic. I even tried out Web. Because everyone was doing it anyway. But it was a big jump for a mobile developer because I'm not just cheating on Android with other mobile frameworks. I was considering other platforms. But anyway, it did not work out. I just could not understand them. It's like all of them had the same upbringing. The soul, the personality was so much similar. I thought Java was better. So I joined this company last summer where my boss tells me, so hey, this is Flutter, be friends with it, it's new to town. And I was like, yeah, getting paid for this job, so why not? But one thing led to another and I kind of stopped talking to Android. Flutter made me realize what it's like to be a mobile developer. It was fresh. It was like feeling like me again. So what is Flutter, by the way? By the way, however I narrated that story, it is completely true. That is how I met Flutter. Now Flutter is a cross-platform mobile development SDK that lets you build Android and iOS apps from one code base written in Dart. Now, Dart was completely new to me. I hadn't even heard of Dart before that, but I was relieved it was not another JS framework. It was even better. It's like you picked up the good things from both languages and then you made Dart. And it was pretty easy to learn. If you are coming from a Java, OOP, or JavaScript background, then you can pick up Dart pretty fast. I actually picked up literally in under a day. Whatever you need for Flutter, I picked up in under a day. Flutter also had this amazing thing called the catalog of widgets. Now, with these catalog of widgets, I can build features that might have taken 3 pages of code in native Android, but it takes only like 5 lines in Flutter. Now, you might not know what widgets are. Now, widgets are like components or blocks that define the user interface in Flutter. The app bar might be a widget. The text on it is a widget. The style that you apply to that text is also a widget. The padding around it could be a widget. Even the empty space could be a widget. Whole lot of widgets. Now let me show you how we actually create a widget in Flutter. So we have something called suppose we are creating a home page, we will extend it to a stateless widget. Now we also have some stateful widgets, but that is not the scope of this talk, so I will skip that. But we have extending stateless widget. Now we have this build function under which we will build anything that is on the UI. Everything that comes in the UI is under this method. Now suppose we return a scaffold. Now scaffold is a widget that lets you have elements and components that is required by a mobile app screen, such as an app bar, a body, a floating action button, a drawer, a bottom navigation bar, a bottom sheet, background color, etc., etc. So suppose we have a scaffold like that and we can want to create an app bar, we give it an app bar widget. Want to create a drawer, we give it a drawer widget. Want to create a floating action button, give it a floating action button widget. Bottom navigation bar widget. And body is everything in between, basically your content of your screen. So that's how you build a simple app. That's how it will look like, with an app bar, a floating action button and a drawer and a content. Now, we are going to play a game. We all are from different frameworks, right? How many are for Flutter? Except Drumil. Okay, others are from Android, React Native, iOS, etc., right? So I am going, though I only know Android, so I'm going to ask mostly about Android anyway, but I'm going to show you features or components that have, that you must have built in your mobile applications, and you have to guess how many lines of code it might take in Flutter based on your experience of your mobile framework, right? So you must have seen a feature like that where you have like, you know, content that you can slide left or right, right? It's something like, I think in Android we call it a view pager, right? So how many lines of code can this take in Flutter? How many for more than 50 lines of code? Raise your hands. How many for more than 30 to 50? How many for like 15 to 30? And how many less than 15? Okay, so for view pager kind of a feature, we have in Flutter something like a page views. Okay, similar name. And to make that possible, we have a body that takes a page view widget, and it takes a children of screen contents. So basically here we have a page one widget and a page two widget, which is nothing but in my case a colored container, like a blue colored screen and a green colored screen. And almost that is it that I require to create that sliding effect. You can also have more features like giving it a control page controller and giving it a viewport fraction, like I just want the content to be on the 80% of the screen. So I give it a viewport fraction of 0.8. And we can also give it a scroll direction as vertical or scroll direction as horizontal. And all of that was done in 7 to 9 lines of code. Moving on, we have this really crazy design. I don't know who came up with this, but then as developers, whatever designs designers will throw at us, we have to develop it, right? So as a developer, I have to design this. Now, how many lines of code can this take in Flutter? How many for more than 30? Okay, no more. How many for more than 15 to 30? Okay, too confident, okay. How many for 10 to 15? What? And 5 to 10? Less than 5? Who are for less than 5? What the rest are, you can vote in basis of your, if you're not in for Android, you can just vote. Just try it out. Crazy design, fine. Now, we have to build an bottom bar, something like that, which has a menu icon and a search icon. And for that, remember we had a bottom navigation bar in Scaffold. We can give it a bottom app bar widget. Again, a widget. Now, we can give it some icons, which is the row of icons, icon menu, icon search. Fine. Not a big deal. Now, for the floating action button, we have the floating action button widget, which is also fine. But we want to give it to the center location. So, we have a floating action button location to center dot. Now, we are almost there, but again, you remember the floating action button is digging the bottom bar. Okay, crazy design again. So, we still do not have the digging effect. For that, remember that we had this bottom navigation bar widget, bottom app bar that was had a lot of code. Now, give just two lines there. Shape, circular notch, rectangle, and notch margin, any other. That's it you require. The entire thing was done in 10 lines of code, but that effect was done in only 2 lines of code. Now, we all have worked on some feature like that, component like that. It's kind of like a collapsing toolbars, right? So, this does take a bit of code in Android, I guess. And how many lines of code do you think it takes in Flutter? So more than 15 lines of code. Now nobody will pick up their hands for that. Okay, more than 5 to 15. Okay, less than 5. Okay, thank you. So we can do something like this with slivers. Now, we have a bot, the body will take a nested scroll view, something similar to like native Android. And we have a body which is basically the content below your increasing app bar, which is the main content. and you take a header sliver builder which returns a sliver app bar. It's not a normal app bar. It's a sliver app bar that can increase the height and it can do a lot of other stuff. There, what other stuff? It sliver app bar can give a take a flexible space bar widget, which is basically that app bar that it becomes after you have scrolled up. So it will also take a background, which is once you have scrolled down, the image that you see once it has scrolled down. And you can also give it a height of that image, how, if you want to fill it the entire screen, or if you just want to have a little bit of to the screen, 30%, 40%, whatever. And that's all. It took around 12 to 14 lines of code to create that in Flutter. Now, we all have some cards like that where we have to create it into a list. Okay, so we have a card like that, a Pikachu card like that, and I want to create into a lot of other Pikachu cards. A list of cards, right? So, I have been just talking about Flutter code and all that. Let's just talk about how much it will take actually in Android, native Android, Java. So, we all, whoever from Java, Android, they know that we have to use recycler view adapters, right? So, recycler view in Java, it will first, the first steps, add the support library, add recycler view to your layout, connect it to your layout manager, attach an adapter, add a list adapter, and it took around 39 to 45 lines of code, just the boilerplate code. I'm not even talking about what is inside that card, it could just be a text, but just the boilerplate code of making that entire list possible took 39 to 45 lines of code. Now, are there any Kotlin party supporters here who are going to say, hey, why don't you use Kotlin, it will reduce the lines of code. So, yeah, sure, for that, the next, it is going to take 28 to 34 lines of code even in Kotlin. Now, tell me how many lines of code it takes in Flutter. So, raise your hands for more than 15 lines of code? No. More than 5 lines of code? Okay, less than 5 lines of code? Alright. So, we have something called a list view builder. And, yeah. So, it will take a list view.builder. It will take an item count, which is, could be a dynamic number or it could be a fixed number. And it will take an item builder that is going to return that card. It could be a text, it could be a card, it could be anything. And that's it. In under 3 lines of code. I'm still talking about the boilerplate code, I'm not talking about the card. So yeah, 3 lines of code for list view. Recycler view adapters, I'm looking at you. So, now remember that card that we made. Let's see how we actually build that card. So we have a row. Now why a row? So row is basically because we want to place elements one after another in a horizontal manner, and we want column when we want in the vertical manner. So for row, since it's beside each other, we have the first element as the circle avatar, which is basically you know the circular image view and all with the cute Pikachu image, and we have a text, Pikachu text. Now if suppose we want to make a detailed view, like we click on it and it will open a detailed view, so it will look something like this probably. Now it will obviously have a column because it is placed one after another vertically. So it will have a bigger Pikachu image and some more Pikachu information. So when we create this application, it will look something like that. Now it's fine, but Pikachu does not like that. Pikachu wants to fly around the screen like that. Have you done that in any of your mobile frameworks, right? So, based on that experience, how many lines of code will this take? So, it's some kind of animation, transition animation if you remember. How many lines of code will this? Any animation takes time, so anyway. So, more than 10 lines of code. More than 5. Less than 5. Flutter, yes. Less than 5. Anyone for less than 5? It's like I'm bidding, but anyway. So, we have something called hero animations in Flutter. Now, why hero? Because it is flying around the screen, but by that logic, it should have been superhero animations. But anyway, So remember that circle avatar we had in that list card? But just wrap it up with a hero tag, a hero widget, and give it a tag. Remember that tag. And remember that bigger Pikachu image we had? Again, wrap it up with a hero widget and give it the same tag. That's it. You have that transition animation done. And Pikachu's pretty happy because it took only 4 lines of code. Literally. So, let's move on to our last feature. Now, we all have these features where we have these apps where we have like a bar chart kind of thing. And it's kind of like a rectangle that basically increases the height according to the values, right? So we make something like a similar simple app like that, where we have a container, which is, the container is just like a div kind of thing. So we have a fixed width, and we have a height that changes, and some color. Now, when we have an on-pressed button here like that, and we give it a set state to bar height to 320. So basically, it will change the value like that. But obviously, it does not give that animation effect. We want it to gradually increase the height, right? So we have to use animation. Now, animation in any framework is hard, right? Like a bit hard. Right? So how many lines of code? This is not going to take like 5 lines of code or 10 lines of code. It's going to take a little more. So vote properly. So more than 15 lines of code. Oh, somebody is nodding. No, it will not take. Okay, so less than 15, or 5 to 15. Anybody for less than 5? Okay, so we have something called an animated containers in Flutter. Now, remember that container that we had with other width, increasing height, and a color? Just replace the container with an animated container and give it a duration. That's all. That's all you require to create that transition or the increasing animation effect. And all of this was done in one extra line of code. So if you create a complete application like that, it will look something like that. If you create a bar chart application. You know what? That looks pretty similar to something that I've seen before. I'll just very quickly move on. So let's move on to Flutter. So Flutter has partnered, like just this December, they partnered with Flutter to improve animations. They want to improve animations, really, more. Okay, so they partnered with Flutter, and now you can create your animations in the Flutter tool with like keyframes and all, and you can add them in your Flutter project. Again, it's probably going to take like 1 or 2 lines of code, and like just to adding the animation, it will take like 1-2 lines of code. If you want to do more, like if you can see here that the teddy bear, whatever, is actually looking at the password or, you know, the cursor. So that will take a little like 3-4 more lines of code, okay. But yeah, then I think it's very, very easy. Now you can have all these crazy animations, and just, if you're a designer, that's so good for you, because now you can have all these amazing animations and just add it to your Flutter project. That's it. Alright. You can do all these amazing stuff with Flutter. Now, so this amazing stuff that is possible, like all these impossible features are now possible, but it also takes 1/3 of the original estimation. Remember that job I talked about where I learned Flutter? I finished 2 beta versions of the 2 projects in under 2 months while I was learning Flutter. And in that same month, I wrote my first technical article about Flutter, which kind of got a little viral, and then it led to more articles and then more opportunities, and here I am standing in front of you. Now, all these crazy projects that you can build, literally, that your creativity limit is literally your sky, literally the sky. Now, fun fact, the first version of Flutter was actually called the sky. So yeah, literally the sky. Now, if you are actually going for any mobile development interview, or you're starting your freelancing journey and you don't have much client projects to show, you can use Flutter to build creative projects in under less time and have a very promising portfolio for yourself. Give an example of a very respected Flutter community member, Devin Joshi, had built this Flutter Solitaire app and the Minesweeper with this Windows, old Windows UI in under 6 hours for each app. Imagine if we had an interview in 10 days, how many apps would he have made? Now, Flutter is literally bridging the gap between the designers and developers. Now, if you are a designer and you want to build quick prototypes for your designs, you can use the Flutter's catalog of widgets to build them and also add interactivity to your prototypes. Now, developers and designers never had a common language. So, what designers would call a floating action button, developers would call a circular button with an icon in the center. So even though I'm a designer and a developer both, I do know my material design terms, but sometimes I do forget and I do Google stuff like these. Where I do know what I want, but I do not know what its names are. Now, you are really, really spoiled for life. So this is one of the tweets that one of our members had given, which is like, Flutter is both a godsend and a curse. It makes everything so easy and efficient that using any other technology becomes a pain. That is so true. If you're literally coming from any other technology and you're using Flutter, I think you will be spoiled for life because you wouldn't want to go back. I don't want to go back to native Android because, listen, did you see the presentation? Like, how many lines of code it took for all these features? The ease of development makes your life so much easier that you don't want to go back. But yeah, adult life, you have to go back sometimes. Anyway, but it depends on what job you're doing. But yeah, so now you can build any kind of apps that you want to build in. That is the aim of Flutter. But I wouldn't suggest you to use Flutter for apps that are pretty, pretty strongly dependent on hardware APIs. Like using the accelerometer or maybe like the vibration or something like that. But if you have already started an application in Flutter and then you realize that you need this hardware-specific APIs, you don't have to scrap off your entire project. Flutter lets you build the Android and iOS code right in your Flutter project. So if you have some kind of hardware-specific APIs that you want to use, then you can have them you can write them in your Android, Java, Kotlin, and your iOS Swift project and have the results returned back to your Flutter project. So that makes me feel that I'm not even cheating on Android, you know. So now these are some of the applications that have been like Flutter community members have just tried out, and these are not the actual app screenshots of YouTube, Twitter, or Medium, or and these are actual apps that are on Play Store and App Store, and you can use them. So this is some of the applications that have been made by the community members of Flutter. So just look at the amazing animations, the fluid designs, the fluid animation. It's so fast, 60 FPS. And I think we can imagine the time it took to make most of these applications. So yeah, that was all the applications that were curated from all the Flutter community members from around the world who are made for their probably the companies or for their projects. So that's where you can learn all the stuff from for Flutter. If you want to learn, there's like GitHub repositories and YouTube channels where you can learn Flutter from. And that's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Pooja. Any questions?